Michael Fassbender, thanks for speaking to us at Absolute Radio. Can you talk us through the phone call that must have been along the lines of, yeah, Michael, want you for the lead role, going to be wearing a paper mache head pretty much the entire time. What was your reaction to that?
Well, actually, I just got the script and read the script and just was, you know, laughing out loud in scenes and just thought it was so original and unusual. I just loved it. And then I seen The Garage by Lenny, and just thought that was beautiful. And so it was an easy decision, really. Yeah, really easy.
Did you come to have a love-hate relationship with that head in the end? Because I imagine it's reasonably cumbersome, is it? It's on the entire time, even in the shower.
Yep, absolutely. It's all love for the head.
It's all love for the head.
I really enjoyed it. It's kind of, there's something quite liberating about wearing a mask. And something that was quite sort of brought out sort of a mischievous side as well. So I really enjoyed it. Just had to sort of get used to the fact that I couldn't see anything directly in front of me.
Right.
Just things out to the side. But yeah, I found it great fun and, as I say, very, very liberating.
We should make it clear this isn't a film about Frank Sidebottom. It's inspired by Frank Sidebottom. There is some Captain Beefheart in there as well. Because I think, you know, a few kind of early responses to the trailer have been, hang on, there's an American accent. And so what have been your responses to that?
Well, this is my first chance to respond. And thank you
Good,
for giving me
for
the
it.
Opportunity. Yeah, I didn't really know anything about Frank Sidebottom, to be honest, because where I grew up, we just had two channels, and it was RTE1 and RTE2, and so we didn't really get any of the BBC channels. And so I didn't know who he was, and it was only when I started talking to Lenny and he said it's inspired by this character, Frank Sidebottom, I started to then do some research and, you know, use the internet and found some stuff, and I was like, wow, that's kind of strange. But the script, he was always American. The band was always an American band. And for whatever reason, you know, I think it was just the fact that there was a spirit of him there. And then the story had its own thing to serve. Well, had its own sort of story to tell, really, and themes to cover. And one of which being, I think, you know, is mental illness. And it's served in a different story that way. So there's lots of influences there. As you said, Captain Beefheart, Daniel Johnston was a big one for me. And and there's lots of different elements within Frank. But I can see, you know, how people would be concerned, especially sort of, you know, fans, diehard fans, and they're kind of confused. That's why they should go see the film.
Absolutely.
And, and just sort of realize what it's all about. Yeah.
How did you feel about singing?
Great.
You've got quite the voice. It's a little bit Neil Hannon Divine Comedy, if you don't mind me saying. Kind of deep and quite
okay.
Sincere.
Yeah, there was lots of different wannabe sort of singers in me probably coming out. At one point it went kind of Jim Morrison-y, and then another time it was John Lydon, and so it was just a lot of fun. We got together, I think it was about 4 weeks before Christmas, to rehearse as a band, and then Lenny's fantastic, and Stephen Rennicks that organized and wrote all the music. They just kind of gave us great freedom within what they had written together. And so we kind of just formed and gelled really well as a group, which was fortunate, really.
Did you ever have any aspirations to be in a band yourself? Are you
sure.
Musically inclined?
Ever? I mean, you say it as in the past tense. it's a constant, it's a daily thing. No, absolutely, you know, music has always been a big influence on me, and I've, you know, that was the first sort of love for me, in a way, and I definitely wanted to be in a band when I was 15, but, you know, I just realized that it wasn't meant to be. My friend came round and played guitar for me one time, and I was like, okay, time for me to try something else. Yeah, and he's still playing. He's an excellent musician. But, yeah.
Well, do you know what? You and I are actually exactly the same age. So we would have been at college, mid-90s, kind of height of Britpop.
Okay, yes.
Topical, but Oasis are reforming. Those are the rumours today. Would you pay good money to see them at Glastonbury? Are they in your...
Sure. I've never been to Glastonbury, and I've never seen Oasis, so that seems like money well spent on both fronts there, yeah.
Okay, so watch this space on Michael Fassbender, lead singer of... What would your band be called?
Frank!
Lovely. Thank you so much for speaking to
us. Thank you, cheers. Thank you.